People again. Okay, I guess we're gonna talk about injuries today. On this week's Discipline Pats, Discipline Weightlifting, we're gonna talk about how to work around an injury. First thing we're talking about is what hurts. In this case, my shoulder hurts. And now we're gonna talk about why does it hurt? Is there an imbalance causing it? Is the back of my shoulder weaker than the front of my shoulder? Maybe. Was I being stupid? Was I going too heavy on something that I shouldn't have been? My form got really shitty and it was just a one-time thing, or it was a really dumb mistake? Or was I just being lazy? Was I not doing the things that I needed to do, like imbalance work, in order to not get injured? So these are the things you need to think about when you're talking about an injury. My shoulder. Now we're gonna talk about what doesn't hurt. Well, this arm doesn't hurt. My legs don't hurt. I might be able to put a bar on my back for back squats. But it's important that while I'm injured, I keep moving. Because the more I move, the more I go through full ranges of motion, like this, the more recovery I'm gonna get. So, more movement, the more full range of motion you get. Obviously, try to get pain-free if you can. Range of motion, the sooner you're gonna recover from that injury. Things you want is also extra recovery, so extra steps. So definitely dial in your sleep, getting at least 8 hours, preferably 10 hours every night. Food consumption, make sure your nutrition's on point. If you're eating like garbage, you're gonna recover like garbage. And lower intensity stuff. So workouts like running, just moving, getting blood flowing through your body like we were talking before. We just want to get nice low intensity, even if it's like rowing or something that you can do pain free. That's what you need to be doing to help you recover. And I guess we're talking about your lighter session. So even moving around injured area with lighter loads can kind of get that blood flowing in those joints and get everything nice and kind of lubricated and moving as one piece again and getting you on the road to recovery. And finally, we're going to address some imbalances. So we're gonna find out what was weak that caused that injury to happen. So again, if it was a stupid mistake, that's one thing. So a one-time thing, that's a different story. But if we're getting injured because of imbalances or because of being lazy, we're not addressing imbalances, then we wanna figure out what those imbalances are. So if I'm injuring my knee, is my core, my quads weak, or my hamstrings weak, or my calves weak? Because there's three insertion points to my knee. Quad tendon, hamstring tendon, gastrocnemius, part of my calf. So we gotta figure out what part of my anatomy is hurting me, and we need to address that. So we can do stuff like single leg stuff to see what's weak on there. We can do a quad hamstring test, like a back squat deadlift ratio test. What else? If my elbow's hurting, is it because of my shoulder? Is it because of my tricep? We're trying to figure out what's weak so we can hit that weak spot and build it up so that that's not a weakness anymore, so that this is not as high as I can go. Anyway, guys, this sucks. That's been Discipline Pats, Discipline Weightlifting, and I'm gonna go ice my shoulder.